This is the opening screen of our Living Things in Their Environment title, which is part of the Forwards with Science series, designed for Key Stage 2 age group or ability range, with some of the screens being suitable for younger and indeed older pupils. Living Things in Their Environment runs on Textees, and that means that you need Textees on the computer in order to view these screens. As you can see, we've got a number of different activities on different buttons on here, opening different activities. If we click on this one, we open the first screen in the title. And this gives an opportunity to talk about the taskbar down here. This is movable and doesn't print, and we have more room to add further information to the screen here. The arrows predictably take us back and forth. That is the full menu button. Click on any of these hotspots to open another title, another screen, and go back to where we were. That is the task button. That is the support button, sometimes images, sometimes words. That is the research button. That is the resource button, sometimes words, sometimes beginnings and endings of sentences, sometimes images, sometimes all of those. And that opens a totally open-ended screen with the same taskbar as before. Here we have everyday living things. These are text boxes to fill in and prioritizing, justifying our thoughts. And here we have a Venn diagram. If we carry on and show you some of the screens we've got here, the importance of light to plants, food chains, more food chains. And of course here you've got quite a few animals and plants. Feeding relationships, number pyramids, more number pyramids. Here we can go to counting plants, sampling activity. We can graph our results. We can do this in the field or on the screen. Here we've got one on microorganisms, and we can do one on counting the numbers of microorganisms using the calculator. We can do microbes that cause disease. We can do one here on living things in their habitats, another one here. Biodiversity of habitats, and follow the information given here so that we can colour the individual cells here, and we could add different animals. We could have maybe a sea anemone here, we could have a moss here, all kinds of different things that we can put on there. And then we can go to classifying living things, quite a few of those. We can go to where this was one I wanted to show you here. This one here, where you've got more labels attached to that, not labels, more descriptions attached to that. And you've got more images here to add and to do that with. And let's see what else we can do. The sampling activity here, which I think we may have already done. And that is enough to give you a brief introduction to living things in their environment. For a full presentation, visit our website and you can get more information about this title, Living Things in Their Environment.